Hello everybody, myself Nirupama Mahanti, senior lecturer in mathematics science, Bose Kotak. Today's most interesting topic is integration by parts. Before going to the topic, let us know what is integration. So integration is the inverse process of differentiation. That is d over dx sin x is equal to cos x. And integration of cos x with respect to x is equal to sin x plus c. Here, integration of cos x is the integrand. And integral of cos x is sin x. Then you have to know what is integration by parts. So integration by parts means product rule for integration or UV rule for integration. Product rule for integration or UV rule for integration. So this rule is derived from the rule of differentiation of the product of the two functions. That is, if u and v are two differentiable functions of x, then d over dx of uv is equal to u into dv by dx plus v into du by dx. Now integrating both sides with respect to x, we get integral of d over dx of uv with respect to x is equal to integral of u into dv by dx plus v into du by dx with respect to x. Now this implies uv is equal to integration of u dv dx with respect to x plus integral of v du by dx into dx. Okay, so this implies integral of u dv by dx is equal to uv minus integral of v du by dx into dx. So if u is equal to fx and du dv by dx is equal to gx, then integration of gx with respect to x is equal to v. Now this implies integral of fx gx with respect to x is equal to fx integration of gx dx minus integral of derivative of fx into integral of gx dx with respect to x. Okay, do you understand me? minus integral of product of derivative of first function into integral of second function. So here the most important it is observed that we have to integrate the second function and differentiate the first function. So the choice of first function is most important. So we have to choose the first function carefully. So applying the rule, the choice we choose the first function according as the order of the letters of the word I left. So I is equal to inverse trigonometric functions. L is equal to logarithmic function. A is equal to algebraic function. T is equal to trigonometric function. E is equal to exponential function. Okay. So, for example, which is the first function and which is the second function? For example given log x into tan x dx. Integral of the product of log x and tan x dx. So here is I let so log is the this is the first function and tan x is the second function. So similarly the functions to be integrated. First function, second function. If the product of two functions is x to the power of n, e to the power of x, then the first function is x to the power of n and second function is e to the power of x. If this is x to the power of n cos x, then the first function is x to the power of n and the second function is cos x. If this is x to the power of n log x to the power of n, then the first function is L. So this is log x to the power of n and second function is x to the power of n. So similarly we have to choose carefully the first function and the second function. Then let us solve some problems regarding this. Now question number 1, integrate x cos x with respect to x dx. So here first we have to choose the first function, then the second function. So in this case I let we have always integrate the second function. So I let, so the first function is, this is first function and this is second function. So this is equal to x into integral of cos x minus integral of d over dx x integral of cos x with respect to x. So this is equal to x. Now using the standard formula of the integrations, integration of cos x with respect to x is sin x, because the derivative of sin x is cos x positive, minus integral of 1 into sin x with respect to x. So this is equal to x sin x minus integral of sin x okay. Do you understand me? So this is equal to x sin x minus integral of sin x is equal to minus cos x, because the derivative of cos x is minus sin x. So this is equal to minus of minus cos x plus c. So this is equal to cos x, this is positive, plus x sin x plus c, and this is the answer. Okay, next question is integrate sin inverse x with respect to x. Question number 2, integrate sin inverse x with respect to x. Here in the integrand we have only one factor, therefore we multiply the integrand by 1, taking 1 as the second factor. So this is equal to, this can be written as sin inverse x into 1 dx. So this is the second factor, second function, and this is the first function. Now this is equal to sin inverse x into integration of 1 dx minus integral of derivative of sin inverse x with respect to x into integral of 1 dx with respect to x. Okay, next, this implies this is equal to sin inverse x into x minus integral of 1 by root over 1 minus x square, this is the derivative of sin inverse x formula, into x dx. Let integration of 1 by root over 1 minus x square into x dx is equal to I. Now I is equal to 2x, 2 into root over 1 minus x square dx. Now multiply the numerator and denominator by 2. So this is equal to, and multiply minus in numerator and denominator. So minus, minus 2x divided by root over 1 minus x square dx. So let 1 minus x square is equal to t. So differentiating this, differentiating with respect to x, we get minus 2x dx is equal to dt. So now substituting the value in above, now I is equal to putting this value in I, we get I is equal to minus half dt by root over t. So this is equal to minus half integration of t to the power of minus half dt. Now this is equal to minus half t to the power of minus half plus 1 t to the power of minus half plus 1 minus half plus 1 plus c. So this is equal to minus half t to the power of half divided by half plus c. So this is equal to minus t to the power of half plus c, that is equal to minus root over t plus c. Now putting the value, we get integration of sine inverse x dx is equal to x into sine inverse x, x into sine inverse x minus of minus root over t plus c. So this is equal to x sine inverse x, substituting the value of t we get plus root over 1 minus x square plus c, where c is the constant of integration, and this is the answer. There are some multiple choice questions, so you have to solve these for practice. So these questions are: MCQ multiple choice questions. Question number 1. Evaluation of integral ln x dx is x ln x plus c, b x ln x plus c, c x ln x plus c, d none of these. Question number 2. Integration of e to the power of x sine x plus cos x with respect to x is a e to the power of x cos x plus c, b e to the power of x tan x plus c, c e to the power of x sin x plus c, d none of these. Question number 3. Evaluation of integral x square e to the power x dx is a x square e to the power x minus 2x e to the power x plus 2 e to the power x plus c, b x square e to the power x minus 2x e to the power x plus c, c x square e to the power x plus 2x e to the power x plus 2 e to the power x plus c, d none of these. Question number 4. Integral of x sin x dx is sin x plus x cos x plus c b sin x minus x cos x plus c c x sin x plus cos x plus c d none of these. Question number 5. Integral of cos inverse x dx is equal to a x cos inverse x plus root over 1 minus x square plus c b x sin inverse x plus root over 1 minus x square plus c c x cos inverse x minus root over 1 minus x square plus c d none of this. Okay, these are the MCQ questions you have to done.